Inside the Trenches, Maul and Big Fave Favor Right, and you are now tuned in to New Orleans Talk Network and ESPN New Orleans 100.3 FM, and you can check us out Monday through Friday, 6 to 8 p.m. Man, oh man, I'm feeling good from last night, so I'm still a little full, so excuse me if y'all see me turn my head to the side a couple of times. The Wings are off the chain at Uptown Sports Social. We had ourselves a good time, a little small crowd last night, but boy, this Thursday will be off the chain because we are getting ready for the NFL draft. But I just really want to talk to y'all guys about college football and some of the most meaningful games in 2024. When the football season kicks off, it's going to be a ton of, I would like to call it, high fly action. A brand new season now, a different mindset in regards to college football and the structure we're used to seeing. CBS Sports put out this this deal via 2024 Sports. It was Brad Crawford that wrote it, and he just mentioned a handful of games that you really need to circle on your calendar. But before I get into the games, we need to talk about Friday, day two of the draft. We're going to be at Small Sliders, baby. 11 to 1 p.m., recapping the first round, talking about the second and third. We are definitely looking forward to that. And remember, you can check it out on ESPN New Orleans 100.3 FM. The first game that they have listed on this list, now I think they ranked it in order to top to bottom games to check out, but you got Georgia, Texas on October 19th. Georgia bouncing back. They fell off last year, but Georgia was unstoppable. Won three national championships back-to-back. Just an unstoppable force. And then they take on Texas. Two coaches that are cut from the Nick Saban's cloth. Big-time game. I like it, CBS Sports. Something for sure to circle on the calendar. If you could get tickets to one game, which one would you choose? That's the question that they're coming with. If you can get a ticket to one game, what is that one game you will choose? Texas, they do lose a lot of guys on offense. Adonis Mitchell, they lose Xavier Worthy to the draft. They lose some guys on defense as well. So they just really, in my opinion, still have a lot to prove. These are two coaches that are cut from the Nick Saban cloth, so that's probably why they're to the top of this list, and I think it's a game worth checking out. Then they have Michigan, Ohio State. That's November 30th. I think that game there is going to be high-powered. It's probably going to be a daytime game, cold wintertime, something to for sure check out. Then there's Ohio State, Oregon. That's going to be big time. Big time game in the city. Oh, excuse me. Well, I'm still tired from Uptown Sports Social. Yeah, it's going to be something to definitely check out. Then there's Georgia, Alabama. That's September 28th. So, big SEC game. This is going to be coaches Keelan Boulder's first big matchup in the SEC. I don't know who they take on prior to that, but I think that if you look at that matchup and how it is intensified, it's something for sure to circle on your calendar. Another thing I like about that game, Georgia, how could I explain this? Georgia does have their quarterback coming back. You got your starting quarterbacks and Steph's, his name slips my mind, but he comes back to your roster. I think I did have it right. Hold on one second, y'all. I'm pulling it together right now. My mind slips me. Oh, damn, this kid's name is on the tip of my tongue. I'm going to get it. But while I'm pulling that information up, you look at a first-year SEC coach and Coach Keelan DeBoyer. He's a first year head coach in the SEC now. So I think for him, the first few games on their schedule is really going to be about, that's it, Carlson Beck. I knew it was at the tip. Like, he's one of the top-rated quarterbacks for next season. Carson Beck is someone to for sure check out. Let's go through a couple more of these. Let me see here. Getting back to the games. All right, so that's one to circle on your calendar. November 9th, you have Georgia at Ole Miss. Another game, another SEC matchup. Lane Kiffin legit has a solid staff. Coming back, he has returning starters. Dart's coming back. He had a couple of players hit the portal, but for the most part, I mean, he's right where he wants to be. On second thought, that game might be better than the other one. Truth be told. Let's see here. Just checking out that Ole Miss's depth chart. I mean, I know you get the starting quarterback Dart back. You have Antoine Wells, wide receiver. He's coming in from the transfer portal. That's one thing about Lane, man. He knows how to play the transfer portal. Jackson Dart, as I mentioned, he's coming back. Logan Diggs from LSU did transfer over there. I found that very interesting with him going over there because I thought he would have had a great opportunity at LSU. But they do lose a few guys to the draft and also to the portal. But Ole Miss is one of them teams. They got enough returning starters coming back on their team and, for the most part, their position. A couple more games here. You do have Ole Miss, Oregon, Michigan. That game should be pretty good. That one is on November 2nd. So Oregon takes on Ohio State October 12th, and then they take on Michigan on November 2nd. Double back, you got Ole Miss, LSU. Now, this is going to be a good one. It's Ole Miss, they come to us, it's October 12th. That game is going to be, that's going to be one of the more important games for LSU this year. One you guys should circle on y'all's calendar. And that's the one I'm going to pick for y'all to come to. It's two of them for sure on this list I'm going to want y'all to check out. But that is for certain one. Ole Miss, they did beat us last year. It was a gut-wrenching game because Jaden Daniels went off. Our offense was really next to none in that game. But our defense, that's when we really noticed that LSU defensively had a lot to work on. And at the beginning of the season, we lose to Florida State again. That kind of drew a red flag of the defense. And then we got to this point with that game. So it's a revenge game for LSU, and it should be a great one. Clemson, Florida State. Clemson has to bounce back. I mean, they have so much. They've lost so much in the draft over the years, and they never really recover from it. Whereas Florida State, probably the whole world felt like they got snubbed last year as they were, you know, held up to the fire when they lost their quarterback and a perfect season went down the drain. Let's see here. I'm still on offense. Let's check this out. All right, so we're looking at Clemson's offense. I don't really see any big-time names that really stick out. And defensively, yeah, it's just so much that they lost to the, and they're not really doing a lot in the transfer portal. So hopefully a star is born for them in that matchup. We'll do a few more here. Turn and look at the clock. All right, Alabama, LSU. I told y'all circle that one. Keelan DeBoer has to make his way down to LSU next year or this football season because it's Alabama at LSU. Another marquee matchup. And it's going to be interesting to see where both of those teams are going to be at that time. The last game that they mentioned is Michigan, Texas. Texas, as I talked about earlier in the schedule against Georgia, they do have their returning quarterback starting, and then Michigan has to reload there, but that defense is there. They lose their head coach to the NFL. So that will be pretty cool to check out and see how that matches up. Well, y'all, that's it. College football's most meaningful games of 2024. I thought that the LSU-Ole Miss game will be one that you guys should circle right there in the middle of the season. But, you know, that's it for us here. We want to thank Small Sliders again for sponsoring this segment, baby. Y'all check us out 11 to 1 p.m. every Friday. We're doing a live remote, big-time music, just a whole bunch of fun, great energy. It's Inside the Trenches, baby. We'll be right back on ESPN New Orleans, New Orleans Talk Network, baby.
Are you a student athlete looking to take your career to the next level? Look no further than Concord Sports Pros. That's right, Concord Sports Pros. Our team of experts will get you guys on the right path to your student athlete journey in life. That's right, we have every position in football you need, and we also help out with other sports. At Concord Sports Pros, you have everything from a list of consultation, training, and also media training. Yeah, that's right. When you take your career to the next level, play college, and hopefully pro, you'll get lots of interviews. Call Concord Sports Pros today. You can reach them at 504-319-6672 or visit MarlonFavorite.com for more information. Hello, somebody.
Hello, somebody. It's your boy Marlon, Big Fave Favorite. And when I'm hungry, I like to make my way to Small Sliders, 1635 Barataria Boulevard, Marrero, Louisiana. Simple on purpose. When I tell you their burgers are delicious, has some great sauce on them, I'm telling you, when you're just hungry and just need to grab a quick bite, this is the perfect place for you. Small Sliders, the customer service is nice. It's somewhere you can bring the family, hang out and chill, enjoy the atmosphere. Now I'm a big boy, so when I like to take my Small Sliders, I like to get the biggest smalls. Double patties, bacon, cheese, you name it. Just a delicious burger. And I like to top it off with my favorite, the cookies and cream milkshake. There are three delicious flavors, milkshake, chocolate, vanilla, and cookies and cream. Small Sliders, simple on purpose. Y'all come on and slide through, baby. And let them know that you heard about them on Inside the Trenches with your boy Marlon Big Fave Favorite. Watch out there now.
Well, hello, it's Marlon Big Fave Favorite with Inside the Trenches podcast. Are you looking for a brand new car? Are you tired of what you're driving around in? Or you just need wheels? Well, if that's the case, you need to visit Montero Motors, 1512 North Causeway, Metairie, Louisiana. At Montero Motors, our buddy Alberto will get you in a vehicle that fits you that day with no problem. They have vehicles that are pre-owned. You can do a trade-in that day and ride off in something that day. Visit MonteroMotors.com for more information. And let them know you heard about them on Inside the Trenches podcast. Hello.
Step Construction is here for you with a brand new offer. We now provide affordable storage sheds. Stop wasting your money on overpriced storage units and portable containers. Step Construction can provide you with a custom shed that will fit your budget and storage needs. So contact Step Construction today at 504-340-5809 for your own personal quote. Let us help you take the next step at Step Construction.
Yeah, Mike, that's the type of intro music for our next segment, baby. Hello, somebody. It's your boy, Big Fave. It's Inside the Trenches. You're checking us out right now, baby, on New Orleans Talk Network, ESPN New Orleans, 100.3 FM, Monday through Friday, 6 p.m. We are here on the dial. And if you want to come to any of our remotes, whether it's at Small Sliders, I told y'all about that 1635 Barataria Boulevard, or if you want to take a ride to Uptown Sports Social and come check us out there on Magazine Street and you need a ride, you might need to holler at Montero Motors. 1512 North Causeway, Metairie, Louisiana, the homie Alberto will get y'all right. You'll be able to come check us out at all the Inside the Trenches remotes because you'll have you a nice ride. And it's a used car lot as well. So he has great deals. Y'all can give him a call at 504-645-5660, or you can visit MonteroMotors.com as well. So shouts out to Alberto. Let him know y'all heard about him on Inside the Trenches. And go get whipped up, baby. Try to figure out what you're going to do with that tax money. Stop catching them Ubers and get your own ride. So the intro music was great, and I thought that Revolt Sports did a good job on comparing some of the best duels over the years in the NFL. Who's the most iconic quarterback and wide receiver duel? So I know some of the guys that I'll mention, depending on our listening audience, you might be familiar with all of them, but also depending on, how could I say this? When you were born, you might lean more one way or other. So I did pull up a couple of stats, and then I'm going to talk about some of the duels and the impacts that they made. So the first duel that they mentioned was Dante Culpepper and Randy Moss. Culpepper and Randy Moss did damage with their time at Minnesota with the Vikings. Dante Culpepper had a passing rating of 92.4 with 17,833 yards, 122 touchdowns with Randy Moss. He threw 73 interceptions in 71 games. So, I mean, those numbers are insane. I mean, they're just crazy. Just kind of looking through this deal, and when no, like Randy Moss, I don't think people understand how insane of a quarter, I mean, of a wide receiver this dude was. Like, he had the burners out of Marshall. He had the burners, the speed, the 4.3 speed. Some even said 4.29. But I'm telling you, he was lame. Like, imagine like Kevin Durant playing wide receiver. He was like slim and lengthy like that, but could let it go. Then you got T.O. and Tony Romo. Terrell Owens and Tony Romo. Now, those two dudes together, they had 223 catches, 3,400 yards, 37 touchdowns, and 44 games. Not bad. I mean, I guess the relationship was like a love-hate relationship, so that's what people remember the most about it, like how these dudes are always at each other's necks. But for the most part, I mean, those dudes were iconic in a small town. I'm not saying that just because I'm a Cowboys fan. I mean, really, those teams were pretty bad. It came close with no cigar, but those dudes had a good duel going. Joe Montana and Jerry Rice. Man, 386 catches, 6,700 yards, 67 touchdowns. I mean, you talking about just over that time frame, just putting up crazy numbers. And it was a time, too. Like, guys weren't as fast. I mean, this is a historical duel right here. I think Jerry Rice really revolutionized the wide receiver position in terms of route running and speed. You talk about the iconic matchups between him and Deion. I mean, this was crazy. Super Bowls that were won at the time when those dudes were together was good. So can't forget about them. Now, this is one that y'all must have forgotten. Calvin Johnson and Matthew Stafford. Boy, that was nice. Back in the day, Matt Stafford and Megatron. Man, like, come on now. Like, I mean, like the timing was pretty good. I mean, I won't say that. I will say that, should I say. The timing was on point. But Calvin Johnson, I mean, for a big wide receiver, he made tons of noise in the NFL. I mean, sometimes they would have like two or three dudes on him and still wouldn't work. I mean, he opened up so many great opportunities for the teammates around him as well. So I'm pulling up this type of wrong. I want to really get into this from a statistical standpoint. These two dudes together played in about 200 games. I want to say this was right at, hold on. Well, I mean, it was right at 7,600 yards. But I just remember it being monumental. Patrick Mahomes and Tyreek Hill. Now, that's recent, so we don't really have to get into the stats and facts. But we know that was just, I mean, It took Patrick Mahomes a minute to recover from not having Tyreek Hill anymore, but that legit just became a thing. Like, for real, though. It legit just became a thing. It was Tyreek Hill's speed and hands and ability to catch the ball in space. And it was Patrick Mahomes being able to be magical with his feet and surgical with his accuracy passing and buying time for the cheetah to get open. I mean, when those two separated, it was a change for both of them. I mean, the cheetah was still able to go on over to Miami and ball, and Patrick Mahomes handled his business as well. So I thought that that was good. Kurt Warner and Larry Fitzgerald. That was big time. The 2008 season is probably their best years together. Two Gold Jacket guys. Most of our listeners may know the Kurt Warner story. He was a bag boy at the grocery store. Played for the Iowa Barnyards out in Iowa. And, man, was just a part of the greatest show on turf. Then came back in the lateral part of his career with the Cardinals, won the Super Bowl. Made it to the Super Bowl. They lost to the Steelers in that 08. But, I mean, they just had a good season. But he won his Super Bowl, greatest show on turf, with Marshall Faulk. But these two guys together should definitely be mentioned as one of the greats. Then you also had Jerry Rice and Steve Young. Steve Young to the later part of Jerry Rice's career. Jerry Rice to the very later part of Joe Montana's career. I mean, the San Francisco 49ers were just that team back then. Even acquiring Deion Sanders, Deion leaving San Fran, going to the Cowboys. I mean, this was a right around that time all that was going down. This is up there. Like, this Steve Young and Jerry Rice one might be top three. Y'all let me know. Add me at BigFade504. And I'm going to take a quick break and talk about the hot list. Y'all make sure y'all text BigFave, BIGFAV, to 94253. Get on that hot list. Unlock some mouth-watering food deals. You can also get VIP to big-time events. Get on that hot list. BigFave, BIG, FAV, 94253. Peyton Manning, Marvin Harrison. That is Peyton Manning and Marvin Harrison. Of course, both of those guys are Gold Jacket guys. But, I mean, if you just look at Marvin Harrison with the route running and his ability to, I mean, and you had Reggie Wayne right there too. I mean, he had two solid receivers. But Marvin Harrison, we'll talk about Marvin Harrison later on too. You know, father and son. His son is probably going to, not probably, he is going to light the NFL up. But Marvin Harrison and Peyton Manning, I mean, the Super Bowl run in 06. Even Marvin, by the time I got to the Colts, Marvin was gone. But Reggie Wayne was still there. So, you know, that was towards the later part of his deal. But in a little over 200 games, these dudes racked it up. I mean, they killed it, almost 10,000 yards. Yeah, that was insane. I hope y'all enjoying this, because I surely am, as we're getting ready for another season. I just want to mention a few more as we wrap up. They had Carson Palmer and Ocho Cinco on there. I thought that was a good one. Oh, that was it. That was it right there. So, shouts out to Revolt Sports for putting that together. Some of the great duels over the years, iconic duels over the years. And we want to thank Montero Motors too, baby, for sponsoring that segment. Y'all make sure y'all check them out. 1512 North Causeway, Metairie, Louisiana. Hit my boy Alberto up. He got you covered like a blanket. Lots of nice used cars on the lot. Y'all could go check it out. Leave with a vehicle today. Visit MonteroMotors.com for a little more information. And when you pull up, say, hey, Big Fave from Inside the Trenches, send me on over there. And they'll get you right. Well, y'all don't go anywhere, man. We're going to continue to enjoy ourselves, talk some more sports here on the show. It's Inside the Trenches right here on ESPN New Orleans, streaming now on New Orleans Talk Network. Hello.
Well, hello, it's Marlon Big Fave Favorite with Inside the Trenches podcast. Are you looking for a brand new car? Are you tired of what you're driving around in? Or you just need wheels? Well, if that's the case, you need to visit Montero Motors, 1512 North Causeway, Metairie, Louisiana. At Montero Motors, our buddy Alberto will get you in a vehicle that fits you that day with no problem. They have vehicles that are pre-owned. You could do a trade-in that day and ride off in something that day. Visit MonteroMotors.com for more information. And let them know you heard about them on Inside the Trenches podcast. Hello. Hello, somebody. It's Marlon Big Fave Favorite with Inside the Trenches podcast. Do you need a quick car wash? Well, if that's a yes, you need to visit Crown Car Wash, 1336 Stump Boulevard, Gretna, Louisiana, on the West Bank, baby. Crown's the best. You get a spotless wash, nice clean tires, reasonable pricing, and free vacuuming. My favorite part about Crown Car Wash, they open 24/7. That's right, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You can visit Crown Car Wash on the West Bank, baby, and let them know you heard about them on Inside the Trenches podcast. With Marlon Big Fave Favorite. Watch out there now.
It's that boy Fred, host of FanView Podcast. Tune into the NOTN app weekdays 3:30 for the FanView Podcast. Go to NewOrleansTalkNetwork.com to watch more episodes of FanView Podcast. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and watch.
Listen up. Your customers, our listeners, could be hearing about your business right now. Yeah, right now. Don't miss out on the opportunity to advertise with NewOrleansTalkNetwork.com. Call our business department today at 504-475-4793 to hear about our great rates. NewOrleansTalkNetwork.com. We provide the people, you provide the business.
New Orleans has a choice. Download the New Orleans Talk Network app for your mobile device or listen at www.NewOrleansTalkNetwork.com.
Well, oh yeah, baby. We back. It's Inside the Trenches. That's right. Marlon Favorite Right. That's the show. Come on, y'all. Go ahead and flow. Inside the Trenches, baby. It's a family affair. This segment about a family affair. That's right. Come on. This segment about a family affair. This segment about a family affair. I ain't gonna lie, boy. That Mary J. beat made me just want to jump into a flow. But the instrumental is also relevant to the segment. It is a family affair. This NFL's year is so interesting because we have a lot of father-son combinations starting their career off here in the NFL. And I think that's pretty cool. You know, coming from a man who was a father of three boys, one plays for Northwestern as a punter, Kentrell. My youngest, he's in this, my second to youngest in Marlin. He's doing baseball, getting ready to play football, play basketball, soccer. Titan, he's just running all over the place. Looks like he's just ready to set the track on blaze. So as a parent, I can relate. And I know these guys are going to be proud as well. We just talked about Marvin Harrison. Well, there's a Marvin Harrison Jr. who just so happened to be one of the top receivers in this year's NFL draft, starting his career off on the right foot. When you look at this kid and his career at Ohio State, and now he's in a situation where he's going to set the NFL on blaze, it really puts you in the mindset of how strong family's genes and how strong family pedigree
runs deep in sports. It's almost like, yeah, it's a bloodline, but it just so happened that these guys are top players. Not always hit every time. This is not an all-the-time deal, but we're starting to see it become a little more common. I think when you look at the type of career that Marvin Harrison had, what he did for the Colts, how he set the NFL on fire, and then his son be one of the top receivers on his team, it just makes you think, man, these guys are going to really set things on blaze. Now, here's another, you don't always catch, like you catch a lot of skill, like you hear the Arch Mannings, Peyton Mannings, you hear you catch a lot of linemen too, but Frank Gore and Frank Gore Jr., now he has a son that is entering the NFL. Yes, they look alike, but they're also built alike as well, and they're good running backs. Now, this article comes from, it's not necessarily an article, it's more along the lines of a Instagram post. Adam Schefter put, you know, one of the things that this draft is going to be known for is the amount of sons who will be stepping in their father's footsteps. And that doesn't always have to be the case. I mean, if you're a kid and your dad played, let's say, professional basketball, you don't have to play professional sports just because he plays sports. You know, you may be a doctor, a lawyer, you know, take a career path. But in most cases, you do see kids at least attempting to walk in their father's footsteps. But for this draft to have this amount of family lineage in it, it's just insane. And it's pretty cool. Jerry Rice and Braden Rice. Now, if y'all check this picture out, y'all got to go to Adam Schefter's page. I follow him on at BigFade504. I might put this in my stories later on tonight. This dude looks just like his pops. Boy, Jerry Rice's son looked just like him. Played at USC, is now starting his career off in the NFL. I think that's going to be cool as well. I mean, what do y'all think about that? Y'all tweet me at BigFade504. You know, what's y'all thought process? I know here with, you know, with the Saints, Cam Jordan, daddy played in the league. You know, you got the brothers deal. We have Derek Carr, his brother David Carr played for Houston. So I think it's pretty cool when you can have the family thing. We talked about legendary Saints quarterback Arch Manning, his sons, Eli Manning, Peyton Manning. Now they got a little nephew that's doing this thing at Texas, is more than likely going to be the next starting quarterback there in Arch Manning. I'm like, boy, these dudes ain't playing. For real, though. No games are played at all. Ed McCaffrey and Luke McCaffrey. Now, of course, there's Christian McCaffrey. Here's the other brother. He played at Rice. He honestly looks more like his dad than his brother does. Like, Christian is shorter neck, too. Well, his neck kind of long, too. They got the little long necks popping, but he's shorter with the long neck. You know what I'm saying? But this kid here is a lot taller, you know, and I think he's going to get his fair shot just off of family lineage. But think about that classic Bronco, those classic Bronco teams that Ed McCaffrey played on. I can remember playing on my Sega Saturn on a Saturday morning when I'm able to get on the game. And I love to get the Broncos. It's just one of those teams that if you were picking them in like 97, 98, 99, 2000, these guys were the names that were discussed and these were the guys that were balling at the time. So I think that's cool that now Ed McCaffrey has two sons in the NFL. Jeremiah Trotter Jr. Now we're talking a little defense here. Switching to the defensive guys. I mean, I thought that Jeremiah Trotter Jr. had an exceptional career at Clemson. I think he's going to do well in the NFL. You know, he has his father's built, obviously, mindset. And here's another cool thing that I look at with most of these situations. You have a situation where, how could I say this? A kid comes up around a facility. You grew up watching your daddy watching film, going to meetings, traveling on the road. You indirectly become attached to that lifestyle, accustomed to it as well. And when I talk about these young men who's following in their father's footsteps, that's when I saw this, when I saw Adam Scheffner, you know, repost this, I'm like, yeah, I'm definitely going to bring this to this segment because I just think it's cool. And I know a lot of parents, even the parents that played on the high school level, college level as well, may have not made it pro. Love to see your kids have those opportunities. So I think that's cool. The first offensive lineman that's coming off the board this year is going to be John O's son. I mean, they look just alike. John O played at the Kansas City Chiefs, had a hell of a career, and his son looks like he's ready to go get a gold jacket. But Notre Dame, right? I think, you look at Notre Dame and you're like, man, they produce some offensive linemen. Most definitely, they really do. I thought that this class, and like I said, it's funny you say, because I remember we talked about this on the show a number of times, even at Uptown Sports Social. Speaking of Uptown Sports Social, this segment is brought to you guys by Uptown Sports Social. That's 3218 Magazine Street, right there in beautiful New Orleans, Louisiana. We'll be there every Monday, 6 to 8 p.m. Y'all come join us for wings. Bring a friend. Be sure to get on the hot list. So, because I think we might send some out on the hot list for next Monday. You know, post-draft gives us an opportunity to, you know, have ourselves a good time. So, y'all be sure to check out Uptown Sports Social, baby, and UPT. That's right, Magazine Street. Good times, good vibes. Lastly here, Chris Jenkins Jr. Now, this dude definitely got his father's arms. Chris Jenkins was a bigger player, played at the Jets, bounced around the league. And, I'm pretty sure he's proud of his son. And I bet you all of these parents are saying, man, time flies. Because you can remember having your kids sitting on your lap when you were a player. And then father time starts to kick in and they grow up. They go to middle school, then they make their way to high school. Then some of them are blessed to have the opportunity to go to college and play. And then that opportunity now opens much bigger doors moving forward here in the future. So I'm excited for these young men in their careers in the NFL. Hopefully they have long and successful careers like their parents, you know, given that opportunity. I think if I would probably pick one guy that may really fit right in his father's shoes based off of his performance that I've seen thus far is Marvin Harrison Jr. I mean, the route running is there. The length he built is there, 6'4". He has one hell of a long neck as well. We're talking about the McCaffreys, boy. Them Harrisons have some necks on them. Then the Gores, they don't have no necks. They're running back, so they got all traps. Shouts out to Frank Gore, man. Frank Gore chopped it up with me and that boy BT. They came down to do the scout thing at LSU, and we chopped it up in the press box. Solid cat, man. Him and the rest of those guys that were in there chilling as well. I hope he don't rip me if he hear this one, but we got to get Frank Gore on the show one of these days here. He said to come on, man, check us out. But, man, we're going to keep this party going, man. It's Inside the Trenches. Again, shouts out to Uptown Sports Social. 3218 Magazine Street, baby, New Orleans, Louisiana. Y'all come on through, man. Make y'all way there, 6 to 8 p.m. You know, every Monday we having fun. Monday night football going to be coming soon. But y'all know all these festivals coming up. They got fights coming up that we're going to watch over there. So y'all come chill with us, 6 to 8 every Monday. Get those dollar wing specials. It's Inside the Trenches, baby, right here on ESPN New Orleans, 100.3 FM, baby. Hello, somebody.
Hello, somebody. It's Marlon Big Fave Favorite with Inside the Trenches podcast. Do you need a quick car wash? Well, if that's a yes, you need to visit Crown Car Wash, 1336 Stump Boulevard, Gretna, Louisiana, on the West Bank, baby. Crown's the best. You get a spotless wash, nice clean tires, reasonable pricing, and free vacuuming. My favorite part about Crown Car Wash, they open 24/7. That's right, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You can visit Crown Car Wash on the West Bank, baby, and let them know you heard about them on Inside the Trenches podcast with Marlon Big Fave Favorite. Watch out there now. Are you a student athlete looking to take your career to the next level? Look no further than Concord Sports Pros. That's right, Concord Sports Pros. Our team of experts will get you guys on the right path to your student athlete journey in life. That's right, we have every position in football you need, and we also help out with other sports. At Concord Sports Pros, you have everything from a list of consultation, training, and also media training. Yeah, that's right, when you take your career to the next level, play college, and hopefully pro, you'll get lots of interviews. Call Concord Sports Pros today. You can reach them at 504-319-6672 or visit MarlonFavorite.com for more information. Hello, somebody. Well, hello, it's Marlon Big Fave Favorite with Inside the Trenches podcast. Are you looking for a brand new car? Are you tired of what you're driving around in? Or you just need wheels? Well, if that's the case, you need to visit Montero Motors, 1512 North Causeway, Metairie, Louisiana. At Montero Motors, our buddy Alberto will get you in a vehicle that fits you that day with no problem. They have vehicles that are pre-owned. You could do a trade-in that day and ride off in something that day. Visit MonteroMotors.com for more information. And let them know you heard about them on Inside the Trenches podcast. Hello.
New Orleans has a choice. Download the New Orleans Talk Network app for your mobile device or listen at www.neworleanstalknetwork.com.
Well, just like that, baby, we cruising through the show. That's right. It's Inside the Trenches. I'm your host, Marlon Big Fave Favorite. And y'all are now checking me out on ESPN New Orleans, Monday through Friday, 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. Got some special dates, too, coming up with the draft, Essence Fest, Woodmere Fest, all the festivals. I'm trying to be at the festivals, too, not only with the pod, but with the music. We're having ourselves a great time because it is up. It is definitely up. And if you're trying to put a house up, sell a house, build a house, find a house, redo it, you know, see something that's for sale, buy it, whatever the place may be, or whatever the thing is you want to do, y'all got to hit up my man, Joel at Godwin Realty. That's Joel at G-O-D-W-Y-N, Godwin Realty. Did I spell it all wrong? W-Y-N. I had it right, like W-Y-N, Godwin. But y'all holler at my main man, Joel. He'll get y'all straight. He's here at least twice a week, so you might catch him here on the show. But he was with us last night at Uptown Sports Social. G was there. CL was there. And, of course, as we do every show, we talk New Orleans Saints because we love our market so much. And then we love our team. And, you know, we're talking draft stuff. But then we started to, like, really look at the quarterback room. So G had his comments. CL had his, Joel had his, I had mine. But it got funny because we're talking about the quarterbacks, and I mean, pretty much all of us agree that Michael Penix, some of us agree if Michael Penix is there, CL's talking O-line or whatever, but I want y'all to check this out real quick. I'm going to play what we're talking about this subject, quarterbacks. And y'all tell me what y'all think.
Especially with A.T. Perry trying to ascend.
That part. You see what I'm saying? I forgot about A.T.
He trying to ascend.
You got St. Brown.
You got St. Brown.
You got Cedric Wilson.
He ain't going to make the final 53.
Who? St. Brown? 6'4", 212 Possession receiver.
What that mean?
So you don't think he's going to make the 53-man
roster? So they bring him into what?
So who?
Motivate who? To motivate A.T. Perry? Because when they bring a guy in, it's to motivate if they plan
to
on
to push him. That's all they're doing.
That's what I was in the NFL. I was a camp body. I motivated the whole time. It was fun motivating,
just like
too.
Kelly Mine. Come on, man. Stop.
We
ain't going to make
We know that's about. On. We know what that's
hold
about.
On.
We know
I will cut. I will definitely cut Nate Peterman. I will definitely cut Jay Hanger. And I will keep Kelly Mine.
You going to cut Jay Hanger? We just spent a fourth-round pick on him last year. Bad business decision right now.
No, I like so who you this like better, Jay Hanger or Kelly Mine?
I want to see what Jay Hanger going to look like under Clint Kubiak.
Oh,
Pete Carmichael was our OC.
I do want to see what Hanger looks like. Okay. I do want to see what Hanger looks like.
Let's see what under he doing the on the clean.
Hold on. All right. Okay.
Yeah. I would cut Kelly Mine before Jake Hanger.
You think so?
Kelly Mine might not make it past minicamp.
I guess I saw him play for Texas A&M, and I feel like he
running around like a back of football.
The thing about Mine, he knows the offense, and he can help out Kubiak.
All right. We are not okay at left tackle.
No.
We're not okay. Boy, these dudes are funny. All of them jump on G-Spot. Yeah, G-Spot, hey, Demeter, why you play with my frog? Look, this is why I said what I said, and I'll say it again. Peterman and Hanger go first. I do think that Hanger is a viable backup, and if something goes down, he can pop in. But if you have this team is missing an athletic quarterback. Derek Carr is not trying to scramble around for yards. You know, they were trying to turn him into Drew Brees 2.0, but it wouldn't happen, Captain. But he is a pro-style quarterback. Jake Hanger is a pro-style quarterback, too. He may have a little more wheels on him. Nate Peterman, it's really hard to describe what type of quarterback he is. But when it comes to the story of Kelly Mine, I at least seen him at Texas A&M, and he is athletic. Like, in terms of built in a way he plays, he reminds me a lot of Colin Kaepernick. He was a drafted quarterback. He has experience under Coach Drew and in his Clint Kubiak system. So definitely Kelly Mine. And then draft Michael Penix. So now you have two athletic quarterbacks behind Derek Carr. I don't know how Derek Carr's season going to go this year. Hopefully the brother has a great season. But if it looks like this is the end. Dun, 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 dun. Are you my friend? Y'all remember that new edition? Look, Mike laughing over there. Hey, you know, his contract might be up and it might be time to go. Or you might turn the tables and, you know, look like Kurt Warner in a couple of years. Who knows? But on at least the duration of his contract. But for the Saints, you need an electrifying quarterback. And you need some. So just like the guys were saying, I want to see how Jake Hanger looks under a Clint Kubiak's offense. I want to see what Kelly Mine looks like in a Clint Kubiak offense. That's what I'm saying. I'm not sitting here saying that Kelly Mine is Kyler Murray or Trevor Lawrence or Joe Burrow or just naming quarterbacks that are starters in the NFL. I'm not saying that he's certainly not saying he's Lamar Jackson. Like, that's not even, not saying that at all. But what I am saying is he gives you a level of mobility in the pocket. He can scramble if need be, so on and so forth. So I think that that's something that should be looked at, just to say the least. All right, so in terms of needs, now, this is what the draft analysts are saying, and I will let you guys know what I am saying in terms of needs for the Saints. There's some things I'm in agreement to, but it's a particular position I think is bottom heavy of the first round, top heavy second and third round. All right, positions of need, according to the position analysts. Offensive tackle, wide receiver, edge rusher, tight end, quarterback, and safety. In that order. In that order. Now, I'm going to pick the same number of positions. This is, they listed six positions, right? I'm going to say tackle is a top need, but if the tackles, the Saints pick at 14, right? The Saints pick at 14, and all I'm saying is if when they get to 13 and Joe Oat is the only offensive lineman, I'm going to say. No, I say tackle. If he is the only tackle that is on the board, off the board, should I say, I'm getting best available. If Michael Penix Jr. is there, I'm getting him. Okay, he gone. Georgia, from Georgia. Bolden, if he's there. Bowen, if he's there. I'm taking him. It's not even up for discussion. I think we're straight at the edge, Russ. Like, I was screaming, let's go get a Jared Verse if he's still sitting there. But I think we can find that really good edge rushers in the fifth round. Like, guys that can come in and plug and play. I think that this draft gives you that. It does. Some other positions of needs. Like, when we get to, like, Friday, Saturday. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Y'all remember that song? I wanna... Won't you be my Saturday? Saturday? Yeah. When we get to later on in the draft, I'll start looking at safety. Now, here's the deal. Best available. The three names, right? Mike, help me out here. We got Bowden from Georgia, right? Adoozie from Washington. Brian Thomas from LSU. Most important position, Michael Penix. Now, let's switch it up a little bit. Let's say, for instance, Joe Oat fall off the board. Teslin Fungua falls off the board. Sorry, butcher your name. I think it's Fungua. Yep, Teslin Fungua. For good. You know what I mean? But nah. J.C. Latham falls off the board. Well, Saints might need to trade up. They got to go get their tackle. Alu Fashanu. Or if he's off the board, J.C. Latham. Or if he's off the board, Tyler Guyton from Oklahoma. Amarius Mims from Georgia. You got to go trade up, baby. That's different. But we'll get into the rest of my mock draft tomorrow. Get into some interviews. Get geared up for this draft. Boy, I'm bucked up. I cannot wait. Looking forward to seeing how this thing going to look, baby. That's right. Well, look, man, we had a great show with y'all. Shouts out to my crew in the studio. Mike and Terry, y'all. Small Sliders. Shouts out to my Terrell Motors, Godwin, Realer T brought this segment to you. That's right. Uptown Sports Social. Oh, what's up? Come on, man. We got this thing going, brother. Shouts out to Conquer Sports, the Bryan Chiropractic Wellness Center, Crown Car Wash, and all of our supporters. We'll be back. It's Inside the Trenches on ESPN New Orleans. Hello.